What's going on, wrestling fans? Nerdy Jace here. It's Monday, so that means it's time for more GM battle here on 2K24. And yep, we're at the first pay-per-view of season number 4, Backlash. So yeah, you know what we do on pay-per-views. We watch all the matches that we're allowed to, so go ahead and get you some snacks and a drink. Got me some peach Sour Patch Kids. Actually pretty good. And also have this Ghost Welch's Grape energy drink. It was very tasty also. You should know from past videos that I'm a big fan of Ghost. And G Fuel also. But, you know, so I'd switch it up with and get the Ghost now because it's new. Again, it's very tasty. Anywho, Backlash pay-per-view. You know, from last video, I got the skeleton of the show. At least I got to move some people around on the card. Got to finish out any stipulations on what. Everybody's on the card, so that's good. I was debating whether I wanted to sign somebody just to go ahead and get this promo slot filled to help with my my seasonal goals, but that's not that big of a deal. But yeah, people looking good. Also in last video, I got the tier 5 stadium, and you know, we're hitting up the Backlash pay-per-view logistics, so that's gonna give me an extra little money and show quality and all that, so I need that. Roger's looking good. I got hit with Regal's power card, as you know, so that knocked down everybody's popularity. Because, yeah, Taker was over a 90. Rhea was almost 80, 70. You know, Post Malone's up there, man. We're doing what I set out to do at the beginning of the season. Just get him up and make him a player. And, yeah, power cards are all right now. I don't have a need to play to the moon right now. I'll do that after the pay-per-view. Depending on how much money I have left, I'll probably go ahead and get this fixed match card, because you know I love that. It's always good to have that in your back pocket for, you know, whatever situation might come. Definitely will need the health spa after. But anyway, let's go ahead and get to the rest of this. So, absolutely starting off the show will be Extreme Rules match. Extreme Rules is the branded bonus for this pay-per-view. So, got Post Malone and Superstar Billy Graham going at it for the United States title. Level 4 feud. So, yeah, going to open up with that one. Both have good popularity and good stamina. Also got Taker and Bray Wyatt in my heavyweight feud. That is actually going to be the closer, of course. Just have a level 1 rivalry because it took a minute for it to, you know, kick off. For whatever reason, but that's fine. I can drag this out to the next pay-per-view. We also got Finn Balor and Big E in a level 3 feud, and then Big E wanted to, you know, wanted a rematch against Finn, which is going to happen anyway, because again, the feud between Big E and Red Monsoon and Finn and Dijak did not kick off, so I'm just going to say to hell with that. Dijak's in a pissy mood anyway, so more than likely he's going to try to bounce. I'm going to put him on the trading block and see what happens. But yeah, I got him and Red Monsoon in a steel cage just to go ahead and blow that feud off. Then lastly, we got Bianca Belair going up against Rhea Ripley once again for the women's title, level 2 feud. So again, another one I can stretch out to the next pay-per-view. So I think it's probably how I'm going to keep it set up. And yeah, over here got tag team promos and then self promos for my women's tag team champs just to get them on the card, get some popularity back up, especially after that Regal Power card, so, you know, whatever. All right. So really, they're not looking too bad on stamina stuff. Part of my seasonal goals, I need to do Ironman matches, but I don't want to risk the extra injury chance with that right now. Tempting as it is, I might do a submission match to go ahead and bump that up. That's one of their specialties. And, you know, stamina cost is medium, but everything else is low, so that's fine. I think that's what I'm going to go ahead and do. I need that to grow more. Oh, yeah, and then, of course, Daddy Triple H wants me to have a schedule a run-in this week. I did it the last week. And it's only for that that talent scout thing, so that's definitely not anything to worry about. Let's see, what do I want to do with these two? Because we got 75 and 45 on the stamina, 61 and 45 right there. So, let's see. Got no holds barred and steel cage, which I don't need to do steel cage because I don't want this to end yet. Oh yeah, loser is injured for a week. I don't want to do that again. So really, it'd probably just be tables. Or I could do, actually I could do last man standing. Let's see what we got over here on these two. Okay, so one of them has a table specialty and a submission specialty, but do I want to do two submission matches? I don't think so. I think a table will be fine. Again, I can build this back up. Over the course of the next 5 weeks after this. Falls count anywhere, extreme. Quality is maximum, high XP. So my only real thing is the stamina. The stamina is extreme. So 75 and 45. I have a health spa 3, so that will help out with it. So yeah, let's go ahead and do a false count anywhere. That'll be a nice feud ender for them. Then yeah, submission match between those two to get them up to hopefully a level 3 feud. If nothing else, it'll definitely be a level 2. And like I said, alright, we're going to go ahead and buy the fixed match. So I got that in the back pocket. I still have my other player power cards. I want to get a couple more contracts, because I got, see, Superstar Billy Graham and Bray. They're my only two contract stuff right now, so I want to get at least one more to get the most out of burning my power card, and then that'll probably be get played the following pay-per-view. We'll see. But yeah, I think that's pretty much going to be the show. Let's do women's tag for my call out. Alright, so yeah, I'm going to write all this down. While I'm doing that, great opportunity again to get your snacks and your drinks. Like, subscribe, share, leave some comments, whatever, you know the drill. Alright, so opening up, Post versus Billy. Extreme title. Alright, next up we got Dijak versus Monsoon Cage to blow off their feud. Oh, wrong thing. Mid-card hump. Bianca versus Rhea. Table a title. We got Finn versus E. Falls Count Anywhere. FCA. And then lastly, main event, got Bray versus Taker. Submission title match. There we go. And actually, I'm going to go ahead and get this other ready. All right, let's do this. Confirm the booking. All right, NXT is up first. So he's got Hell in a Cell, normal, Iron Man. Okay. Natalya with an 83 popularity. Okay. Alba winning. All right, starting off with a 4-star match. Okay. So that had to be a power card. There's no way that's getting a 4-star right off a level 1 rivalry. Kofi and Omos. See, there we go. Okay. Oh yeah, I guess what, Shane is hurt, I believe. Oh, he's doing the double call out. Wolfpack's back. Brett and Karrion Kross. Hitman winning, all right. 3.5. Cause of mass destruction. Bad Boys of Wrestling. Elton and Johnny. He's the North American champ, okay. 3.5, okay, so 4-star was at 2.5 for the second one, 3.5. Angel and Josh, Iron Man match. Angel, 5-star match, shit. That's gonna be a tough to beat on the end. All right, EC Dubs. All right, Iron Man, normal, table, normal, no holds barred. It's got Dusty Rhodes. I'm actually kind of upset about that. I'm jealous. 3.5, okay. He's not in his polka dot singlet. Eddie Pop and Olaf Ostrovsky. Eddie Pop with a run-in from Jinder Mahal, okay. Kyle Slipman versus a piece of shit. Piece of shit wins. The tag team women's action. Zoe and Tamina, okay. Miz beating Randy. Randy out for a week, yeah. 4.5-star, okay. All right, here we go. Oh, what? Can only simulate an Extreme Rules? Oh, wait a minute. Did I use a fixed match to make Post win? I think that's what I did. I think I... four and a half. Okay. I think I did that. All right, so Post. Post Malone is the United States title holder once again. All right. 4.5 stars. So I tied... Tied Heyman. Good, level 3. Needed that. Alright, spectate. Yeah, I totally forgot about fixing the match. But again, I wasn't sure if I was going to re-sign Billy Graham also. Oh. Die, Jack.
Here comes the Tower of Power. Die, Jack.
That's right. 1.5 of the tag team champs. Homegrown talent, baby. Came up through the WCW power plant. Blood, sweat, and tears. Climbed his way up the ladder to become a legend, and then eats a big-ass clothesline right off the bat. It's like, gives a shoulder tackle to, and then a flex. Shoulder tackle flex, that's what he thinks.
You might lose your ability to see. Some high stakes here.
Come on, Byron. Don't be so soft. These superstars know that every match might be their last. Steel cage.
A knee lift.
So they lay it on the line.
Thigh lift.
True, every match has elements of danger, but the steel cage takes it to a
Dijak getting his ass whooped right off the bat. Oh, shit. Big right hand.
And that's why the WWE Universe loves it.
Getting ever so close to the very peak of the steel cage.
Oh.
Trying desperately to escape.
Oh, there goes his knee.
Trying to make their way out of the cage. Oh, no! From the top rope!
He takes a painful fall from the cage.
Uh-oh.
Yeah, that was anything but graceful. Planning on what to do next.
Hanging him up on the top rope. Oh, going for the pin. Okay.
Lifts the shoulder up.
Too early for that.
Kick out at 1. So, yeah, I don't know about you out there, if you have HBO Max, or I'm sorry, just Max, but the new Penguin series, big boot from Dijak, excuse me. So yeah, the Penguin series, just good lord, big spinning kick. Penguin series just dropped episode 1, and yeah, that's just going to be good, son. So it's still Colin Farrell as the Penguin. It picks up right after the Batman movie with Robert Pattinson and Zoe Kravitz, and I can't remember who else was in that movie. I forgot about Clancy Brown being in it, playing Salvatore Moroni. But yeah, that's going to be good.
He clearly has no intention of staying.
Again, I love what they've been doing with the Penguin. Really, even since big power slam from Red Monsoon. Even since the Gotham series, because starting off he was just kind of a joke character in the comics or whatever. Like even in the animated series, he would do some cool shit in the series, but then again, still kind of. Really playing into the actual Penguin thing. But with the Gotham series and then like video games, Gotham Knights, even that too. and the comics here lately, showing him as the gangster, the mob boss and everything. I love that. Just showing how ruthless he can be.
The story of this cage match is getting written on these competitors' bodies.
So yeah, they've already started channeling that in the series, and I'm all in for it. It's going to be good. Oh, misses that spinning roundhouse.
Taking a moment to get pumped off of this crowd's incredible.
So yeah, I definitely recommend checking it out if you have Max. Ooh, knees to the ribs of the big man. And I know the Batman movie is kind of a little bit divisive. I think from what... Oh, like how the hell did he dodge out of that? A lot of people that I've talked to... Dijak?
Yeah, Dijak put a little extra oomph into that one.
Like you either love it or hate it? Uh-oh.
Up across the shoulders...
Oh, go to hell from Dijak. Kick out at a long one count. I liked it. I wasn't sure if I was going to like it. Again, the stigma from Robert Pattinson from, you know, the Twilight bullshit. I thought he did good. One of my main complaints from Big Splash from Red Monsoon. Probably my big complaint from the movie is it's way too dark. I mean, granted, it's a Batman thing. You do want a certain level of darkness into it because, you know, he's all hiding in the shadows, causing the fear, yada yada. But it can't be so dark that you can't see the details that you need to see. And that's my opinion on games also. You know, you see me playing Resident Evil and some other stuff where it wants you to, you know, just barely see the thing. Like, no, I want to be able to, yeah, I still want to be scared or whatever, but I still have to be able to visualize it. So it's the same thing with that. And I don't know, it was definitely an interesting take on the Riddler. Not my favorite, but I mean, I went with it, you know. Again, it was, they took inspiration from the Zodiac Killer, so that's whatever. But all in all, I thought it was a really good movie. And again, just with the series picking up right after that, and you know, some of the fallout and everything. Carmine Falcone's dead, so you know the mob families and stuff, you know, Gotham, the underworld of Gotham is up, is in play, up for grabs, so that's just going to make for an explosive scenario, as we saw with Gotham. If you haven't watched Gotham, definitely go watch it. Yeah, there's some hokey shit in there, but I mean, again, that's just how those type of shows are, but a lot of the characters in there, they are really good. I love the Riddler in Gotham. Penguin, Robin Lord Taylor played a great Penguin. Fuck Jada Pinkett Smith in general, but she was good as Fish in there. Was it Fish Mahome? Just the characters were great. You know, Batman was an afterthought, you know, Grant, because it was still like young Bruce Wayne in there. So definitely, you know, other takes on the characters. It was really refreshing. 3.5 star. Excellent.
The more dangerous they get.
But again, we saw, you know, turf wars and stuff in there between the mob bosses and things like that. So. And that was on Fox. That was on, you know, what, network television. This being on a premium channel service or whatever. Excellent. Three popularity. So this should be, you know, it should be right here with it. It should be taking it up here. So I'm I'm definitely excited for that. I guess it's going to come out every 2 weeks, maybe, because the next episode doesn't come out until September 29th. So this upcoming Sunday or whatever. So, yeah. Me likes. Definitely looking forward to it. Especially, you know, once they set up the Iceberg Lounge again. Because, you know, the Iceberg Lounge, Oswald, you know, brings that up, and there's so many, you know, dealings, you know, on both sides, whether it's dirty or the up and ups coming in to do business and stuff, just seeing those kind of interactions. And then, you know, eventually, you know, we might get, you know, the Scarecrows, the Two Faces, maybe the Joker. I don't know. Depends on how they want to go about doing it. Definitely not Juggalo Joker. But yeah, I'm not sure if they keep talking about doing another movie. I think they're back and forth on it. Oh, big boot right off the bat from women's champ Rhea Ripley, and then another. Was it Matt Smith was the director? I know him and James Gunn. I guess that they're working together to get the new DC universe set up. So I think they're back and forth whether this Batman's going to be a part of the new vision or whatever, or if it's going to be its own separate thing over here. I can't remember right now. But again, hopefully, I would love them to continue on with that. Again, just to see the newer renditions of these classic characters that we've also seen, you know, again, that just to build on what Gotham did. So, yeah. Check it out if you haven't. Oh, spear.
Up and around.
Oh.
The world slam. Boom. Right oh. Across the small of the back.
Yeah. Anything back related. Ugh.
Oh my God, what impact.
Yeah, because I have lower back issues here and there.
Look at this.
And Rhea flies over the top.
Absolutely throwing all caution to the wind.
Spitting in the face of danger.
But yeah, luckily nothing's happened in a while. Just my knees kind of messing with me here and there. But even that's been better too. Knock on wood. Bianca was dragging Rhea over, but taking too long. Oh yeah. So the new nice slam. Oh, but Bianca is like, nah, going over to the table. Nope, back in the ring. So the new character packs out again. Hopefully this will wash out the stank and the garbage from that Pat McAfee bullshit. So yeah, this one has Carlito, Nia Jax, Jay Cargill, Kairi Sane, Dragon Lee, and is it Lyra Valkyrie? I think that's her name. So, you know, some actual wrestlers to start, so that's good. But yeah, hopefully they'll be good and
what's she gonna do with this table?
Maybe try to get Kairi.
What do you think she's gonna do, Zach?
Carry on the brand, you know, keep with her damage control buddies in EO and Dakota.
The table carefully being placed in the corner. Bad intentions, no doubt.
In the electric chair.
Uh-oh.
Can they somehow counter?
Dropping bombs. Trying to escape.
Uh-oh.
She's between a rock and a hard place right now.
Oh. Is this it? It's Bianca the new champ. Oh! Face first breaking the table. Shit, Bianca. Face plant. And new. Alright, what we got? Amazing match, 4-star, excellent, and the rivalry grows. That's what we like to see. 4-star R3. Excellent. 4.5, 3.5, 4. Good. Back-to-back excellent promos. Both my tag champs gained 3 more popularity back from the 5 that Regal took. At least his power card's already been used. Jesus, that means Paul's going to hit us with his next pay-per-view, more than likely. Mm-mm. Oh, I can get Carlito and have him be part of the new Judgment Day with Ben.
And it's time for the WWE Universe to face their judgment.
Finn Balor.
There is a big change in the atmosphere.
Big E. Oh yeah, going back to Penguin. So that is something. I want something like that. I want Star Wars to do something like the Penguin. I want the down, the gritty, underworld bounty hunter, whatever stuff. You can sprinkle, you can throw some Jedi shit in there every so often. But give me the underworld. Crime syndicates, bounty hunters, you know, on both sides, whatever. You know, throw some Han Solo types, you know, whatever. But give me that gritty shit. That would be amazing. Oh, big splash from Big E. It can be done because I've seen it. I want that on a show and in video games. Because, yeah, I guess same thing with the Star Wars Outlaws game that's out from Ubisoft. Why is Big E just going in circles? Apparently the same thing. It's either you love it or hate it right now. I'm going to wait until Game Pass or Steam Share if one of our buddies ends up getting it.
Expertise to work there, making it look just
but same thing. It can be done because they've done it in to a certain extent. In oh, big drop kick from Finn. They did to a certain extent in KOTOR, Knights of the Old Republic, but they expanded on it in the old Republic MMO, which I still want to. I need to get back into playing that since I've had my, you know, better computer. I just haven't called or emailed them about getting my account information and shit back. Because yeah, there's, you know, especially if you go like the bounty hunter route and maybe even like the soldier route. You know, you go to all these other planets. You go to Nar Shaddaa. You go to the Hutt planets. I can't remember the name of it right now, whatever. But, you know, you have your whole little quest lines and stuff on that. And, again, you can throw some morality shit in there, just like KOTOR or whatever. I don't understand why that's so hard of a freaking concept.
Double leg takedown. Crushing double stomp.
He thinks he has it.
Hell, get Respawn to do the fucking game, because they did great on
truly impressive kick out.
Was it the Jedi Survivor game or whatever it's called? And again, Respawn with Titanfall, and I guess Apex Legends is still going pretty strong. They did that too. But yeah, it can be done. So I don't know why it's such a fucking hard concept.
In the corner he goes, a perfectly placed target.
He's able to take a stand there.
Yeah, he got tired of being pushed around.
Let me, you know, create my character. And then, you know, throw me into the universe. Throw me into that giant sandbox and let me freaking play in it.
No need to rush.
But, whatever. Anyhow, so far, nice match between these two wrestlers. Oh, Finn is busted open.
You can see just how bad it was all over his face.
Big hip toss.
Was definitely not thinking about finesse with that one. Was only thinking about dominance.
Boom, big clubbing blow from Big E.
Not exactly looking like the best version of himself after that one.
As Big E was reminding him just how serious he can be.
Uh-oh.
Oh, what we got?
Oh,
back body drop on the or back suplex on the apron.
This could be a key moment in this contest. Down they go.
Keep dealing punishment.
Finn able to get out of the way.
What was that whiff, Big E? Come on now.
Pressing their foot right into the gut. That's gotta hurt.
Yeah, so far, still don't know if Big E's ever gonna wrestle again. Why are you going all the way around, ref?
Not even at one count there.
You could have went that way up under the apron and got it, but no. Refs suck in this game, man. Too slow.
Bashed right into the post on the outside.
And then stomps on the ankle. So yeah, let me know your views and opinions on not only the Star Wars stuff that I just mentioned, but also, you know, the Penguin series, if you watched it. Yeah, let me know in the comments. Misses the leg drop. Yeah, definitely be interested in what your thoughts are. Oh, atomic drop.
He's in a little bit of trouble now.
Big E just put his entire massive frame behind that move.
Finn has a coup de grace. After this, Big E should have a big ending. Nope, not yet.
I'll watch this display of power.
Deadlift slam from Big E.
Big E has the inside track now. Round the waist.
Oh.
Spine buster. Such a potent display of power and control there.
I wouldn't exactly call that a spine buster, but oh, big clothesline.
FTO blitz. Nicely done. And he's taking this to the outside now.
All right, both gentlemen have a finisher in the bank.
Always under the ring in the ninja attacks.
That never gets old.
Ooh, that's a kick that would leave a gasping for air. And that might be the start of the momentum swing. Ballard.
Oh, 1916. 2, 3. Finn picks up the win. Classic 4.5. Rivalry complete. Excellent. All right, again, another great pay-per-view so far. All right, main event time. Submission match, Bray Wyatt, Undertaker. WCW Heavyweight Championship.
Championship. Bum, 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 bum.
Firefly workout. Again, those fucking pants.
This is the demented power of Bray Wyatt.
Rex Quando. Hey, there's a random sledgehammer and table out through there. I guess that's for the Extreme Rules Falls Count Anywhere stuff.
The Fiend has arrived. An ominous
Rex Quando. Just go ahead and speed this up, because, you know, I don't want 20 minutes of him come to the ring.
Look at the adjective. Championship.
Title on the line. Again, we'll see if this bumps up to a level 3 rivalry. Yes, get it on.
Competitor to WWE for nearly 2 decades, even eclipsing WWE's popularity for a long time. So winning a WCW branded title.
Big body slam to start off from Bray, and followed by a clothesline. Yeah. Elbow drop. Yeah.
WCW meant you were among the best in the world.
You're right, except for the times that that movie star and the writer won the title. Otherwise, it's pretty much the best of the best.
Got a forearm.
So Bray. Bray coming out strong right out the gate.
Trying to wrestle free their opponent's arm, has the arm trapped. Oh, stop right to the hand. And Wyatt with absolutely crushing offense.
Bray is firmly in the driver's seat.
The stomp in every single part of his body. The champ getting put to the test here.
And again, and the fanny pack also cracks me up.
Inflicting punishment and loving every second of it.
Stretching and tearing at all the ligaments in the leg. Now trampling the opposition.
Shit, Bray. Bray's coming out like he really wants that title. Like a man possessed. The champion hasn't gotten any offense on as of yet. That could change right here, though. Nope. Back body drop. There it goes. Now we've got some counter. Big elbows from the dead man. And then his running DDT. Misses a drop kick.
Showing some extra scouting, knowing how to answer a counter with a counter of your own.
Big boot. Nope, another big back body drop. Face first. Snake eyes.
Here we go. Snake eyes.
And the boot. And the leg drop.
Leg drop for the exclamation. The challenger eating up some damage.
So he's dropping the straps already, but he doesn't have. Well, he has a choke slam, though. Are you going last ride? Shit.
I've seen this so many times before.
All right, we going Hell's Gate.
And you fight
And one way or another, it tends to...
Great trouble here. Can he get it fully locked in?
Nope.
Exhibiting a crazy...
No Hell's Gate anyway, but got a submission attempt. Gets out.
Looking wobbly in the corner.
Oh, this is so...
He's dancing into the Sister Abigail.
And it follows it up with Sister Abigail.
Wyatt giving into those dark urges and just letting go.
Is it mandible claw time?
And here we go.
Now going for a single leg crab. And now, but he's right there by the rope. Why are you not grabbing the rope?
Single leg Boston crab. Oh, wow. Look at this. Hopped up. No way.
Yes way.
What power.
And they're off to Tombstone. Population Bray Wyatt. So you're going for Hell's Gate?
Knew what was coming from Taker. And look at this.
Oh, mandible claw.
Coming with his hold. Oh,
is he going to tap? Nope.
Body breaks free, but will the damage prove to be irreparable? Hits him with the counter.
Look out.
Oh. A choke slam.
And Bray just taunting his opponent.
Choke slam spine buster, I guess you would call that. I don't know.
Clothesline right to the back of the neck. The champ in a worst case scenario. He can really stand to get back as good as he's getting right about now.
Knees up.
He was laying in wait.
Undertaker retaliates.
All right.
Oh, look out.
Oh.
High speed crossbody from Wyatt.
Always liked seeing Bray do that crossbody because he puts so much impact into it. Oh, just rubbing his face on the mat. Damn. Shoot, he almost has his finisher again. Taunting the Undertaker. Not the best move there, dude.
So frightening. So bizarre. So eerie. Welcome to worse to Sister.
Sister Abigail again.
Sister Abigail.
Oh, this is just too.
I'm just gonna choke him out.
Some control in there. Oh, it is aggression, just pure brutality.
Come on, easy.
To the high rent district.
He has him right where he wants him.
From the top, blow to the abdomen, gets him out of that.
Misses the double axe handle.
Two-handed choke slam.
Coming down with a leg drop.
Dose leg drops.
And he's already taken more hits up there than he should have to handle.
Really just laying.
Okay. Okay, Taker, you got finisher also, so you get the Hell's Gate.
No desire to ride out into the sunset.
Bray, you need the mandible claw again. That should get it this time, I would think.
He's got him by the neck. Look at this.
High impact choke slam. Two finishers now.
Is he thinking of a submission here? Camel clutches in.
Look at the torque. Oh no, this is not where he wants to be.
Right now he's looking for anyone.
Damn, so why isn't he going for Hell's Gate? There's Mandible Claw.
Mandible Claw.
That should be one of his submissions. Possibly, you know, finishers.
Uh-oh, this is not going to look pretty. Submission being applied.
Now Bray doing it.
To the hold.
Nope.
I don't think he had it fully locked in.
Climbing up top, he's got
going up top again.
He's looking completely lost as he finds his footing.
It's going to hit this time. Gets it this time.
Oh man!
Big fist. Another one.
Dangerous position here, guys.
Oh, no.
Here's the apron drop.
The heart is part of the ring.
Another Sister Abigail. Shit, he's hit, what, three now? One on the outside? Is he going for another one? No, Mandible Claw on the outside.
This is just terrible to watch. He's in so much pain and can't do anything.
Why are you counting? You can only win by submission. There's no fucking count outs.
Oh, look at that torch of their opponent.
Again, why have they not fixed that?
Oh, man. Goes under the ropes to get back inside. Bray setting himself up.
He's
top.
On the fucking...
taking flight.
Big splash.
Wyatt with a debilitating chain of maneuvers.
Bray has clearly frozen the opposition with fear.
Ripping at the eyes. A square shot.
He's an elbow that time, though.
The dead man has the
tombstone again.
Now. Tombstone from the Undertaker.
But champions need to finish the job.
One more time. One more time. Now you need a slap on Hell's Gate, man.
Hold on a second. Could be.
Why do you keep doing that? I don't know. Whatever.
Being locked in. Will this match end on a submission, on a tap out?
It has to, Cole. That's the stipulation for the fucking match.
Oh no, he can be caught here. Bad spot for him. The
dead. Because hey, he's right there at the rope.
And Wyatt telling the crowd to watch it.
Elbow to the heart.
Actually, that was the back, but whatever.
Oh, with
to the back of the head. Oh, now Bray's busted open with that big DDT.
Undertaker turning up the intimidation factor.
Oh!
Little gut check right there. Stop fucking counting.
Hope he's got a plan.
Oh, a little hip toss.
Took advantage. Caught in a bad position here.
Oh.
This is just too far. Get some control in there.
Oh, it is aggression, just pure brutality.
Come on, easy.
Four.
They are feeding off the WWE fans, now pinning the arm down and
delivering nasty stops.
Back in the ring now.
Breaking up the count.
He's testing fate here in danger of a count out.
You can't get counted out in a submission match.
He climbs back into the ring just in time.
For fuck's sake. Last ride.
I don't know where the lights go out.
More importantly, where'd Byron go?
What the shit?
Get back here, Saxton.
I don't know what the hell. Oh, there it is. The Mandible
Claw. Oh, I think that was one of Bray's little things. But the Mandible Claw doesn't finish him off.
Wait a minute, setting in. Devastating submission coming.
An extreme amount of pressure.
And he wins. Okay.
Champion. Unbelievable.
I would have liked him to win with the Mandible Claw, but whatever. And amazing. It's a damn. I get poor finale, but it gets up to level 3, which is what I wanted also. Okay. So again, I get poor finale, but other than that, I mean, great power, great pay-per-view. 4.5, 3.5, 4, 4.5, 4. Okay. Oh, so yeah, poor finale. Host with a 57, Billy Graham with a 36. Okay. 55, 38. Damn. 33, 4. How'd you lose that much on just a table match? God damn, Finn. Glad the robbery's complete, because you're definitely going to the hell spot, which I pretty much figured that one anyway. Bray with 35, that's fine. Amazing booking, good booking, yeah. Okay. It's got 60-54. Okay. Beep. Come on, man. All right, made a decent chunk of change. All right, hell of a show. Post Malone's match was my favorite part of tonight's show. Superstar Billy Graham put in such a good effort, though. Big props. Cool, cool. You gave it a good shot, Undertaker, but your good isn't on my level. Ooh, shit. Okay. Alright, we got trade stuff. No, you're not getting Post Malone, fool. No. No. Yeah, you want Post Malone back after I built his ass up? I don't think so, son. Let's see. Well, I want to trade Dijak. Dijak's pretty much the only one I want to trade. Possibly Billy Graham. All right. What does he have that I may want? Regal doesn't have anybody that I want, really. All right, let's go to EC Dubs. Definitely don't want that piece of shit. It's R-Truth still. Zero stamina, did not get injured. It's dusty. Mm-mm. I want Dusty. I don't know what I would do with Dusty, but I want him. All right, so let's do some quick maths right here. If my phone will come up. All right. So that's 192,000 plus. So that's 273,000 to his 211. So let's do this. Do I want anybody else? That's low. I don't really want Olaf or Eddie, so let's try this. right, so I got Dusty Rhodes and $30,000.
Sweet.
Got the American Dream, baby! Back on WCW. In trade. Now, is he going to come back with anything? Nope. Okay. So now we're going to SummerSlam.
Till I'm victorious.
All right, let's go here first. Thanks for title rematch. And you're new once again. Moderate. Thank you. Thank you for moderate increase. Just brought a physical trainer. They have a sit out show. Yes. Yeah, because Bianca's a 33, Finn's of that, so yes. I would do that for the 30,000 that I just got from EC Dubs. Yeah. Argus the Great, baby. He is a heel giant. 73, yeah, so I'm Argus the Great, you may have heard of me, no? Well, I'm a pretty big deal on the internets. Yes. All right, here we go. Shake up card. PR training, all of my female superstars get +3 mic skills. Fan favorites gain morale and rule breakers gain 5 popularity. Famous interference. Run-ins generate $500 for each point of popularity. The star running in has over. Ooh. View roster. Wait, was that over 60? But see, that's gonna fuck with my show stuff too. Now, is it better to do that or do. Just go ahead and gain morale and popularity? That is very tempting because it's always good to have money. Oh, and that's only for 5 shows, isn't it? I think I'm gonna do the morale and the popularity. Again, as tempting as that is, because that's too much other shit. There's too many moving pieces for that. And that can be detrimental because it can knock your match quality down also. So I'm gonna do classic booking. And there we go, another contract negotiation courtesy of The Undertaker. Alright. We're gonna go through looking at some other stuff real quick, but I'm gonna take a quick second. Be right back. See, why didn't I get an email from Big E saying, hey, you know, thanks for rematch, that was on me, blah, blah, blah. All right, have at least one Hell in a Cell match this week. You freaking crazy. Ooh, but bad timing. That's tempting. Actually, you know what? I could possibly do that with my women's tag. But hey, all right. Show logistics. I'm not blowing my budget on one of those. All right, so my roster. Well, fuck, actually, I could, no, because Bray's at 35 stamina, so I definitely can't do that. All right, so my women's tag got Dakota with a 69. Charlotte and EO 61. Dusty. I get Argus a great for two cycles. That's nice. Damn, he still didn't get enough XP. So I need to get, oh, what we got? Pre-match physio, we got contract negotiation. I do have my To the Moon, so that's good. Joel Wheeler, Clay Courtman. Oh, Clay has a little bit of XP. So what do I need? Yeah, Dusty as a specialist, really? Submission, stamina, so he can go Specialist Bruiser, TLC Workaholic. This superstar gains 8 stamina instead of 6 whenever they cut a promo. Shit, son. Okay, that's awesome. That is awesome. They don't want none. So I need some more, because I got what, 1? Two. Only got 3 male heels right now, so I need some more heels. I don't know what I want on that yet, so let's go that a male heel. Don't really care on class because both of them are specialists. So let's go establish renowned icon. This point, I think I have to do, I have to start at Icon and then go up. Icon or Legend would be the other one thing. So let's try this. So we got Kane, Jimmy Uso, another Bray, and we got MVP. I don't want MVP back. I really don't want to sign Kane for that much. Could do Jimmy Uso, because I had him, what, very briefly. That's not what I want. That's what I want. Hell in a Cell, especially, of course. Basic power card and Bruiser, so Giant Bruiser. Stream, basic cruiser fighter. So I think I want to go Jimmy, because he costs less. Popularity is slightly under, but he has a little bit. 4 or 5, 3 out of 5.
Yeah, I'll see.
Yeah, I'll sign Jimmy Uso. Now let's go ahead and do this. Let's go main event, tag team, Hell in a Cell, title on the line. Let's go Fatal 4-Way. Argus the Great. Jimmy Uso. Dusty Rhodes. And our champion, Post Malone. That'll be a US title on the line. And I could possibly use my To the Moon on one of them. Maybe use it on Argus. Or I could, yeah, maybe, we'll see. Word life. This is basic Thugonomics. But yeah, that's what we're going to do right now. I might go ahead and get all three of these. For only two, all right, I think that's what we're going to do at least right now. That'll get me the bad timing, so that's select an opposing brand, reduce the length of one of their contracts by 1 week. So, I mean, that's something. I can go ahead. Let's go ahead and play one of my negotiations. Actually, let's go ahead and use my Just a Minute player. Just a Minute player. No, that's on my other one. Classically Trained. So I got Dusty now for 3 cycles. Got Argus the Great for 2. Jimmy for 2. Right now, Bray for 1. FABULOUS. Let's go ahead and do a call out just while I'm thinking about it. No, I'm not going to do that. I want Bray to get some more stamina back. Fuck ass. I might have to risk. So I think I'm going to have to risk that. I can just have Big E and Red Monsoon do a match. Or who else can I sign? Cortman, Cruiser. I mean, they're both about the same. Satisfied. He has. He's more just because of his popularity. But I don't want to spend 13.5.
You can't say my time is now. You can't see me, my time is now.
Let's just do one on one. I guess I'll do Clay. Do Clay and Big E. Holy shit, Bianca's going up to 83 fucking stamina from that. That's insane. That's 5,000. Cell Pro is 25. Well, I guess that's pretty much going to be my starting show for next vid, then we'll go from there. Anywho, thanks for joining me on this pay-per-view edition of my GM Triple Threat. Thanks for joining me as always. I appreciate it. Like, subscribe, share, all that good stuff. Until next time, wrestling fans, Nerdy Jace is out.